it is important for us to learn how to handle instruments well, since they truly are the surgical extension of our hands. In this module, we will cover some open surgical instruments. Instruments that open and close with the help of a joint have the following parts. They are finger bores, where we grip the instrument, a ratchet that helps lock the instrument in the closed position, a fairly long shank that eventually leads to a joint, which is a box joint in this case, or it may be a hinge joint in the case of scissors. The end effector of the instrument is a jaw, which ultimately interacts with tissues. Do not concern yourself too much with the exact names of the instruments. The same instrument may go by several names across the world. Hemostats may be curved or straight. When gripping a curved hemostat, the curve usually points down at the surgical field. The jaws of the hemostat are milled transversely, regardless of its shape or size. A needle driver has a tough and short jaw, which is milled with a diamond pattern for grip. It also possesses a longitudinal groove that further improves its hold on the needle. This is an intestinal occlusion clamp with atraumatic longitudinal milling across the very long jaw. Observe the difference in proportions between these instruments. The jaw represents the load arm of the instrument on one side of the joint, whereas the shank serves as the effort arm. When the effort arm is significantly longer than the load arm, the force extended at the jaw is greater. This principle is evident in instruments like the needle driver, which is designed specifically to grip needles tightly and should never be used to grasp tissues due to the risk of crushing them. Conversely, at the other end of the spectrum, we have the intestinal occlusion clamp. It is intended to be atraumatic and features an effort arm, which is about the same length as the load arm.
Moving on to forceps, there are two primary types, toothed and non-toothed. Plain or non-toothed forceps typically feature transverse milling and offer a less secure grip, making them less effective at holding needles securely. Ironically, non-toothed forceps can be more traumatic as they often require more force to grip tissues, increasing the risk of injury. Non-toothed forceps are typically reserved for delicate soft tissues like the liver, spleen, bowel, kidneys, and ureter. Therefore, toothed forceps are actually more commonly used at surgery overall. Most toothed forceps feature two teeth on one side and a single tooth on the other. When manipulating skin, it is important to position the jaw with more teeth within the incision to minimize trauma to the skin surface. This aids healing as well as cosmesis. Vascular, atraumatic, or DeBakey's forceps are equipped with special milling that is not only gentler on tissues as compared with tooth forceps, but also helps grip needles well. These versatile forceps are invaluable across various forms of open surgery. Always hold forceps with a grip that is similar to that of a pen or a pair of chopsticks to maintain optimal control.